感谢哈林根主席，感谢大家给我提供了这么好的一个机会，让我来介绍一下中国“十三五”规划的有关情况，而且这个机会还是免费的。
I want to first give my appreciation to Chairman Hellingen and thank you all for giving me this great opportunity to introduce to you the five-year plan of China. And also this opportunity is free of charge.
中国从1978年开始搞改革开放，到现在已经走过了38年的路程。
China started the reform and the opening up from the year 1978 until now. It has been 38 years.
昨天晚上我在想啊，我今天在这儿给大家介绍“十三五”情况，中国的发展情况的时候，我用一句什么话开头呢
？Last night, I've been thinking over and over when I start the speech today to introduce to you the 13th Five-Year Plan of China. How can I start my speech?
我扳着指头算了一下，七八年到现在是38年，于是我想到了我们毛泽东主席的一句诗，他说：“38年过去，弹指一挥间。”
I have counted the years from the year of China's reform and the opening up, the 1978 until now. It has been 38 years. From the 38 years, I have think about a famous poem.Of Chairman Mao Zedong, and he has been said, have 38 years have passed just like a blink, or a flip of fingers.
弹指一挥间就是说，38年看起来很长，实际上过得很快。
It means 38 years. It seems a long time, but it's very fast.
毛泽东主席还说过一句话。一万年太久，指针朝西。
Chairman Mao also has another very famous saying. He says that 10,000 years is too long. We should start work now.
他是希望我们发展的再快一些。
He hopes that China can develop faster.
我又想到我们有一个老百姓讲，38年过去，我要有住房。
And the public, the general public of China, they are saying they hope they have a house to live in after the 38 years of reform.
这句话的意思就是说，他想分享改革开放的成果。
It means that the public they want to share the fruits of our reform and opening up.
的确，当今世界各个方面的人，欧美的、发展中国家的。我们中国的乡下的农民，他都在关心中国下一步怎么发展，中国道路能不能坚持下去。
Indeed, I think the people from around the world, from other countries, from the European countries, from the United States, and the people from the urban and rural side of China, they are focused on the same issue that is that sustainable for the Chinese development path?
刚才跟哈林根主席交谈的时候，他提出来想了解中国五年规划是怎么制定的，十三五规划这个有什么具体内容。
Mr. Hellingen has said he want to know how the five-year plan of China has been made.What's the process of making the five-year plan, and what's the specific contents of the five-year plan?
So, 我今天呢，我先给大家介绍围绕这个主题介绍三个方面的情况。一个呢，第一个问题给大家介绍一下，我们做了什么？38年我们做了什么？第二个问题给大家介绍一下，我们要做什么？今后五年我们要做什么？第三个问题给大家介绍一下，我们怎么做？
So I will focus on three aspects for today's speech. The first aspect is what we have done in the past years. The second aspect is what we are going to do in the next 5 years. And the third aspect is how we do it.
过去的三十八年，我们在改革开放道路上，给中国经济发展注入了强大的活力。 中国的面貌发生了翻天覆地的变化。今天的中国已经成为总量上已经成为第二大经济体。就国际贸易来说，我们已经成为货物贸易的第一大国。
In the past 38 years, we have put a lot of vitality in the Chinese economy, and we have been through huge changes in China's economy and society. Today, we have been the second economy in the world, and also we are the biggest commodity exchange countries in the world.
那么这三十八年，我们在发展方面做了些什么事呢？概括起来，我个人觉得我们做了五件事。
So what we have done in the past 38 years, personally, I think there were five major things we've done.
我们做的第一件事叫做走向市场。
The first thing is we have been market oriented.
大家知道，我们过去实行的是计划经济，这种体制对新中国经济的发展曾经发挥过积极作用，但是由于这种体制脱离了市场规律，违背了市场规律，所以发展到一定阶段就严重束缚了我们生产力的发展，我们走不下去了。
You may know that China has been a planning economy since the start of the 1949, the new China, and this planning economy had played a positive role in the starting phase of the first several years. But this kind of planning economy is a violation of the rule of market economy, and we cannot maintain that. It has been a constraint for our further progress.
因为我们改革的一个主要内容就是在中国建立市场经济体制。
So one of the major objectives of our reform is to build up a market-oriented economy in China.
今天的中国，我可以这样讲，已经高度市场化了。
Today's China, I can say, we have already built up a market-oriented economy in China.
我们党的三中全会做出一个决定，就是让市场在资源配置中发挥决定性作用。我们得到这个认识是经历了一个长期的探索过程的。
The third plenary session of the CPC Central Committee has made the decision to build the market economy in China. I think this decision is based on our long-time exploration.
我们最初的想法是要让计划经济和市场经济相结合。
We are thinking that we combine the planning economy and the market economy.
后来我们认识得到了进一步发展，提出来要让市场在资源配置中发挥基础性作用。
And later, after practice, we think we should make market as a basis for economy.
我们党的十八届三中全会在这个基础上提出要让市场发挥决定性作用。
So, based on this, the third plenary session of the 18th Central Committee of CPC have made the decision to make market as the decision factor of the resources allocation.
从1978年开始改革开放，到2000年，我们初步建立了市场经济体制的框架。
So we started the reform in the year 1978, and we finished the building of a market economy in China around the year 2000.
现在我们正处于市场经济体制完善过程中。
And now we are trying to optimize our market economy in China.
我们的目标是再努力五年左右，建立更加成熟、更加定型的市场经济体制。
Our objective is to build a more matured market economy in China in 5 years.
这一件事对中国经济的快速发展提供了体制保障。
and the building up of the market economy system provide a system support for our reform.
它对中国的意义在于把市场经济的原则和社会主义原则结合起来了，我们叫做社会主义市场经济体制，探索了一条成功的路子。
And the significance of the market economy in China is that it combined the characteristic, the rules of market economy and the characteristic of socialism. So we call it the market economy with the socialism characteristic.
当初我们提出这个目标的时候，有人怀疑社会主义能和市场经济结合吗？现在在中国确实做到了。
When we brought up this objective, some people are suspicious that is that possible for the market economy to combine with the socialism? But now we have done that.
我们做的第二件事叫做走向富裕。
The second thing we've done is to build a prosperous society.
走向富裕的反面叫做走出贫困。
The other side of the prosperous society is alleviation of poor.
改革开放刚刚起步的时候，我们人均国力生产总值只有$155。
When we start the before we start the reform and the opening up, the GDP per capita is only $155.
那时候呢，我们国家在世界上处于极低收入国家的行列。
At that time, China is the lowest income country in the world.
从1978年开始，我们用了12年时间，到1990年，国力生产总值人均国力生产总值达到了$400。
And we've tried to do work in this field, and from year 1978 to the year 1990, through 12 years, we have improved our GDP per capita GDP to $400.
按照联合国提出的标准，这个时候我们处于下这个这低收入国家的行列。
According to the UN standard of the poverty.We are then at the lower end of the low income countries.
从这时候开始到2000年，我们用了10年时间，是人均国力生产总值达到突破了$1000。
And from 1990 to the year 2000, we have improved the per capita GDP income to $1000.
对我们中国人民来说，这是一个历史性的突破。
For Chinese people, it's a historical.
我们解决了6亿多贫困人口的温饱问题，实现了较低水平的小康。
We have make 600 million people in China. We feed them and make them have clothes, and then they have a basic livelihood.
从2000年到2010年，我们又用了10年时间，是人均国力生产总值超过了$4000。
And from the year 2000 to 2010, we have improved the per capita GDP income to $4000.
从2010年到2015年，我们5年时间，人均国力生产总值翻了一番，达到$8000。
And from the year 2010 to 2015, we used these 5 years to double the per capita GDP income to $8000.
这就是说，中国整体上已经进入了上中等收入国家的行列。
This means that China has been one of the high and middle income countries in the world.
今天中国旅游者在世界各地慷慨采购，是有着丰厚的收入支撑的。
Today, a lot of tourists from China, they become famous of buying things in foreign countries. I think this is because they have higher income compared to yesterday.
总体来看, 我们用38年时间, 解决了7亿多人口的贫困问题, 使我们国家整体上 迈向了小康。
In general, I think China used 38 years to lift 700 million people out of poverty and in the process of build a well-off and moderately prosperous society.
这是我们做的第二件事情。
This is the second thing we've done.
第三件事情叫做走向世界。
The third thing we achieved is to go internationally.
我们78年开始的改革开放, 两方面内容, 一个内容对内, 改革体制, 第二个内容对外打开国门, 走向世界。
I think in the reform and the opening up start in the year 1978, we've achieved the two things. The first is domestically, we reform our system. The second is to open to the world, to go internationally.
那个时候，我们货物贸易进出口量居世界第29位。
At that time, we are ranked the 29th in the commodity exchange in international market.
现在，我们货物贸易进出口量居世界首位。
Now we are the top country of the import and export of commodity.
2010年之后, 我们连续几年超过英国、德国、日本, 然后就美国进入第一位。
After the year 2010, we have outpaced the Britain, Germany, Japan, and then United States to be the top country of the import and export of commodities in the international market.
25年前, 我到日本去参加中日高级经济会谈, 在银座的商店里面, 找不到一件中国的商品。
When I visited Japan 25 years ago, I've been to their mall, and I cannot find any Chinese commodity there. I was there to attend the high-level economy conference, but I cannot find the Chinese goods in their malls.
进入新世纪之后, 中国得到了一顶桂冠, 叫做世界工厂, 中国制造。
25 years later, China has been the world factory, been called the world factory, and made in China.
当然我们知道, 中国制造还不等于中国创造。
But we understand that made in China do not means create by China.
仅此一项, 我们中国对世界经济的发展要做出了巨大的贡献。 一个贡献是提供了价廉物美的商品, 满足了各国人民消费需求。
I think we have made some contribution to the world in this aspect because we have provide low-cost, high-quality products to the world.
第二个贡献就是拉动了世界经济的强劲增长。中国经济对世界经济增长的贡献超过了美国。
And also, I think we play an important role to enhance the world economy progress, and this contribution from China is even higher than United States.
第三个贡献就是中国给世界经济增长这个黄金期提供了广阔的市场。
And also, I think China has been a great market to the world in this era of progress of economy.
中国做出的这种市场贡献, 在有些人那个地方是没有得到承认的, 因为他们只看到自己的市场, 看不到别人的市场。
Some countries cannot see this contribution as China being a market to the products around the world because they can only see the market of their own country.
第四个贡献就是中国 通过加入世贸组织，促进区域合作，这样一种实践，给世界提供了一种互惠互利、繁荣发展共享的一种理念，一种包容性增长的理念。
And the fourth contribution of China contributes to the world economy, I think, is we joined the WTO and we contributed to the regional cooperation, and we have brought in the mutual benefit concept and make the economy fruits being shared and inclusive.
今天的世界，就经济发展来说，离开中国元素是不可想象的。今天的媒体离开中国话题也是不可想象的。
I think it's hard to imagine for the world economy to live without China and for the media around the world to live without China today.
这是我讲的是我们做的第三件事，走向世界。This
is the third thing I've introduced to you. This is about the third thing we achieved in the past years.
第四件事，走向法治。The
fourth thing we accomplished during the past years is the rule of law.
中国是一个有着几千年人治历史的国家。
We have a long history of several thousands of years being the ruling of men in China.
改革开放前，我在新中国20多年的发展中，我们自己领导人民建立了法治，我们亲手又把这个法治破坏了。
Before the reform and the opening up, as you may know, actually the new China has originally set up a system of rule of law, but later it has been crushed by the China government itself.
中国人民吃尽了法治被践踏的苦头。
Chinese people have suffered a lot from the crush of rule of law.
我们改革开放的历程啊，实际上就是一种走向法治的历程。
So the process of reform and opening up was actually a process of building up the system of rule of law.
到2000年，我们适应市场经济发展的需要，建立了法律体系的基本框架。
Until the year 2010, we have built up a legal system according to the needs of market economy in China.
现在我们面临的任务就是要建设现代法治性国家。
Now, the challenge we are facing is to build a modern state rule of law.
这是我们做的第四件事。
This is the fourth thing we achieved during the past years.
我们做的第五件事就是走向未来。
The fifth thing we've achieved is to go into the future, facing the future.
从改革开放之初开始，我们党就制定了中国经济社会发展三步走的战略目标。
From the very start of the reform and the opening up in China, the CPC Central Committee has set up three steps for our reform and opening up for the economy and society.
在以后的发展中，我们对这种三步走的战略目标不断加以完善。我们党的十八大实际上提出了新的三步走战略目标。
And during the past decades, the Chinese CPC Central Committee and the central government has been adjusting their strategic objectives according to the Chinese situation, and I think the 18th National Congress have set up the new three steps of the strategic objectives of China.
在30多年改革的过程中，我们为中国经济走向未来打下了体制基础。
During the past 30 decades, we've set a good foundation for China to facing the future.
在30多年快速发展的基础上，我们为中国经济走向未来打下了坚实的物质基础。
And I think during the past three decades' efforts, we've built a good economic foundation for China to face in the future.
在三十多年教育改革的实践中，我们为中国经济的未来发展提供了坚强的人才保证。
And also, through the efforts of the past 30 years, through the reform in the education sector, we have built up a talent pool for future China.
我们每做一件事都想到未来，怎么样更好地走向未来。
Everything we done, we've been thinking about the future. How can we better prepare us to face the future?
这是我今天给大家介绍的第一点，就是我们做了什么。38年，我们做了五件事。
This is what I want to share with you today. The first aspect, that is what we have done during the past 38 years.
第二个问题，我想讲一讲，我们要做什么。
The second aspect I want to share with you, what we are going to do.
概括起来，今后五年我们要做的事就是一件。全面建成小康社会。
If I put it in one sentence, I think what we are going to do in the next 5 years is to build a moderate, prosperous society.
全面建成小康社会，我们以前的提法叫做全面建设小康社会。建设是一个过程，建成是一个结果。
About this.Build up a moderate prosperous society, we used to use the word construction. We said construction of a moderate prosperous society. But today we have changed a word. It's the finished building of the moderate prosperous society. It means we complete the process of building the prosperous society.
就总量指标来说呢，但是我们到2020年，我们国内生产总值在2010年基础上翻一番。
Put it economically, I think we want to double the GDP in the year 2020 compared to the year 2010.
这个概念大体上就是说，然后100万亿美元以上。
This means we will achieve about 100 trillion.US dollars GDP in the year 2020.
第二个是人均指标，就是人均国内生产总值到这个2020年的时候呢，大体上要达到12,000美元左右。
And this is also means per capita GDP in the year 2020.Should achieve $12,000.
也是要在2010年基础上翻一番。
It will also double the number of the year 2010.
这大体上就是我们要做的事情。这就实现这个指标，我们把它叫做全面建成小康社会。
In general, this is what we are going to do in the next 5 years. If we can achieve this, I think we can say we finish.Building up of a moderate, prosperous society in China.
十三五规划主题就是全面建成小康社会。
I think this is the main theme of the 13th five-year plan: is to build up a moderate, prosperous society in China.
我就以十三五规划的制定为例，给大家介绍一下中国五年规划的制定过程。
I think now I will introduce to you the process of the making process of the 13th five-year plan as an example of how we make this kind of five-year plan during our government, the past years, how we made up the five-year plan.
制定国民经济发展计划，这是前苏联的一种做法。前苏联1923年开始制定第一个五年计划，根据这个利昂体夫他们搞的那个投入产出表，他们搞这个第一个五年计划。
And I think the five-year plan, this kind of practice, we've learned it from the former Soviet Union. they start this kind of planning in the year the 1950s, and they based this plan based on the input and the output.
改革开放之后, 我们把这种, 以指令性计划为主, 这样一种经济计划的制定方式, 做了改革。 先把它变成这个指导性计划和指导性计划相结合。
But after the reform and the opening up in China, we have made change to the process of the making up of this kind of plan. Before, we just give orders, but later we made this plan like a guidance to the government agencies.
后来有经济发展计划, 把它扩展为经济社会发展计划。
And also we broadened the areas the plan covered. At first, it only focused in the economy, and later we brought in the aspect of society development.
1990年, 我们把计划改为规划, 这是一个重大改变。
In the year 1990, we changed the philosophy. We changed it from the planning and top-down to guidance.
规划的意思就是说提供一种宏观思路，一种政策保证的体系， 提供一种指导性的指引导性的指标。
And we have made the ideology or philosophy of guidance into the planning to make the plan like a direction or a policy, supporting policy for the society and the economic development.
So, 1995年开始, 我们制定规划, 不再光搞五年的规划, 而是一个滚动式的规划, 五年, 十年, 二十年, 五年, 是一个五年规划, 十年呢, 在五年规划里面有一部分, 要规划五年之后, 像先接那五年, 后五年的这个发展。
And from the year 1995, we made another change to our planning process. That is, we not only make five-year plan, we also make 10-year plan and 20-year plan to make this planning of different time frame integrated to each other.
同时, 每个五年规划都有一个20年的奋斗目标。
And for every five-year plan, we set an objective for 20 years.
具体的这个规划制定过程要经过制定和实施过程要经过六个阶段。
And for the decision-making and the implementation of the planning, I think there were six phases.
第一个阶段叫做调查研究阶段。
The first phase is doing research.
这个阶段要做几件事。第一件事，中共中央要给全国各级党组织发一个文件，要求 全国各级党组织和政府研究本辖区内经济社会发展的趋势存在的问题，以及今后发展的目标和措施，给中央提出建议。And
there were several tasks during this research phase. The first thing is the Central Committee of the CPC, that is the central government. They will issue a document to different level of CPC committees and the local government to ask them to do research to do research in their prefectures in their different localities according to the trends, the problems, the challenges and the objectives they are facing of their regional situations, economy and social development.
第二件事情就是由国家发改委牵头，根据经济社会发展的需要，确定一些专项的课题，在全国范围内开展广泛的调查和研究，理论研究。
The second task of this phase is the NDRC of China, the National Development and Reform Commission. They will implement research projects focused in specific fields.
比如，十三五期间，怎么样实现脱贫？怎么样解决环境问题？怎么样转换发展动力等等。
For example, for the 13th Five-Year Plan, the NDRC, they will carry out research concerning the topics of poverty alleviation, environment protection, and also how to have more growth engines for the economy.
第三件事就是我们中央政府的领导同志要到各个部门和全国一些地方，这亲自去开调查研究的座谈会，听取汇报，到现场去了解情况，和老百姓交谈，了解他们的期待和愿望。
The third task concerning the research phase is the leaders from the Central Committee of CPC and the Central Government. They will have conferences and discussion sessions with different government departments, agencies, and with different localities of government and public agencies to hear from them their opinions about the future development. And they will do field study and have conversation with local public, with local people to hear about their expectations from the government.
第四件事就是从各方面抽调一些力量，组成文件起草组，分别负责规划纲要的起草和党中央这个建议书的起草。
So, and the fourth task of the research is to have a document, the drawing up team of the document. There are several people. They will set up a team.They will write a draft of the proposal to the central government and also the framework of the five-year plan.
第二阶段叫做提出建议阶段。这个阶段主要是根据第一阶段提供的各种资源，有文件起草组起草中共中央关于第十三个五年计划纲要的建议。
The second phase of the building up, the making up the five-year plan is to give proposals. Then the team just mentioned, they will have a draft of the proposal about concerning the five-year plan to the central committee of the CPC.
这个建议的起草也是要经过四个环节。第一个环节，先要拿出一个基本框架，把主要的问题提出来，让各方面去讨论。
There were four steps to make up this proposal or policy advice about the five-year plan. The first is to provide a basic framework for discussion.
第二个环节就是拿出建议的初稿，在决策圈内，就是决策核心圈内进行讨论，征求意见。
The second step is to make a draft of the document of the five-year plan and to have it circulated and discussed among the core decision makers of the central government.
第三个环节，在这个初稿的基础上，形成征求意见稿，下发全党讨论，征求意见。
And the third step is to make a draft after the circulation of the draft documents among the major decision makers of central government and different levels of government. We will update the draft and make it circulation in the whole party to have people's opinions.
在全党讨论的同时，我们的中央领导同志要带着征求意见稿。分别征求我们的民主党派、参政党的民主党派的意见。
And At the same time, the leaders of the CPC Central Committee, they will bring this draft document to the other parties in China for them to discuss and give their opinions.
第四个环节, 召开中央委员会全会, 讨论审定, 这个制定, 13五规划建议稿。
And the fourth step is to hold the plenary session of the CPC Central Committee to discuss the proposal, the draft of the five-year plan.
这就是大家知道的, 我们13届五中全会的建议。
This is what you've seen from the fifth session of the 13th Central Committee of CPC.
第三阶段叫做行程规划阶段。 叫规划纲要的阶段。
The third phase to offer the making up of the five-year plan is the formulation of the five-year plan.
党中央的建议全会通过之后, 国家发改委牵头要根据建议制定13个五年规划方案的纲要, 各部门要制定各自的专业发展的专项发展纲要。
So after the CPC plenary session have voted through the proposal of the five-year plan, the NDRC will draft national guidelines for the implementation of the five-year plan, and every department, ministries, and agencies in China will have to draft their plan in their region and in their fields, respectively.
这个规划纲要也要下发的各地区征求意见。
And this guideline of implementation of the five-year plan made up by the NDRC will also go through the process to give it to discussion of different levels of government and different departments to have their opinions.
这个规划纲要经过广泛征求意见修改后，由国务院全体会议审议通过，提交全国人大。And
then the NDRC will update and have adjustment to their framework after they gain opinions from the people and the different departments, and afterwards they will submit it to the plenary session of the State Council, and afterwards this document will finally to go to the National Congress.
中共中央的建议实际上是一个五年期间发展的路线图规划图。
So we can say, actually, the planning from the Central Committee of CPTC is like a development path for the country to follow in the next 5 years. And the implementation framework built up by the NDRC based on the five-year plan actually is implementation plan of the next 5 years.
第四个阶段叫做审议通过阶段。
The fourth phase, we call it approval.
就是把规划纲要提交全国人民代表大会全体会议审议。
In this phase, we call it discussion and approval phase. We will submit the draft five-year plan to the plenary session of the National Congress.
根据人民代表讨论审议的情况进行修改后，全体会议通过，它就具有了法律效力，实际上成为一个法规。
After the discussion and approval by the deputies of the plenary session of the National Congress, this document finally will have their legal identity and become a law in China.
第五个阶段叫做分解落实阶段。
The fifth phase, I call it the implementation phase.
规划经全国人民代表大会通过审议通过后，由国务院负责，将规划按部门、按地区加以分解落实责任，使之成为各部门、各地区今后五年工作的一个指导。
After the 5-year plan being discussed and approved by the National Congress, the State Council will have this document. issued to different ministries, departments, and regions and localities in China. And these departments and localities, they will make it as a responsibility and objective for their next 5 years work.
第六个阶段叫组织实施阶段。
The sixth phase, I call it to make the 5-year plan into reality, how to implement it.
组织实施阶段三大特点，第一个特点就一系工作围绕分解落实的责任、规划确定的目标进行。
I think there are three characteristics in this phase. The first is we will divide the overall objective into different parts and into different levels.
第二个特点就是在规划实施的过程中，遇到客观条件发生变化，可以及时反馈，进行由全国人民代表大会进行修正。The
second characteristic is during the process of implementation, if there were some situation or problems coming up unexpected. And the people, the public, and the different level of government and departments, they can give feedback to the State Council, and they can make adjustment to the document and have it approved by the State Council.
第三个特点就是把规划通过的奋斗目标作为干部考核的主要依据。
And the third characteristic about the implementation of our 5-year plan is to we will evaluate our civil servants as how they do their work to achieve the objective of the 5-year plan.
这是一种目标管理和特殊的激励机制。
I think this is an objective-oriented management, and this is a way of a good stimulation of their work.
这就是我们要做的事，我给大家做个介绍。And
this is what we are going to do in the next 5 years.
第三个问题，我讲一讲我们怎么做。The
third aspect I want to share with you is how we do it.
我们"十三五"规划提出了一个政策和措施的保障体系，内容很丰富。
The 13th 5-year plan is quite rich in the content about the supporting policies and how can we make sure we achieve the objectives.
时间关系，我概括十句话给大家介绍一下。
Because the short time, I think I just concluded in 10 sentences of the contents.
第一句话。 发展观念要新。
The first sentence is we should have a new ideology for development.
因为我们认为，在一个五年规划甚至更长一段时期，经济社会发展，这个发展观很重要，观念很重要。
I think we should attach great importance to the ideology and the philosophy of development in 5 years or even longer terms.
所以我们"十三五"规划，这提出了这个创新、协调、绿色、共享等等这五大理念。So
we have brought up 5 philosophy or ideology for the 13th 5-year plan. Is there are innovation, coordination, green, shared,
开放
and opening up.
这五大理念创新解决我们发展的动力问题，协调解决发展的布局问题，开放 解决发展的国际环境问题，绿色解决我们发展的自然规律问题，分享解决我们发展的目标问题。
I think these five main concepts of our development philosophy give us the solution to five different areas. For example, the innovation, it means the engine of our future economy growth, and coordination focus on the layout of our economic development, and opening up means we need an international environment to develop. And the green means we have a harmonious development between the human society and the natural environment. And also the shared economy means our objective to share the fruits of economic development.
第二句话，宏观政策要稳。
The second sentence is,we must have stable macro policy for development.
就是财政政策、货币政策等宏观政策要保持战略定力，保持稳定，保持连续性。
So this means our fiscal policy and currency policy should be comparatively stable and strategic and sustainable.
第三句话叫做区域政策要协调。
The third sentence, I call it the regional development should be coordinated.
就是说，中国面积很大，不同地区发展水平不一样，要针对不同的地区实行不同的这个区域政策，促进他们协调发展。
This means China is a huge country. Different regions are in the different levels of development.So we must make it possible for them to develop coordinatedly.
第四句话
balanced
叫做结构政策要优化。
The fourth sentence is we should optimize our structure.
所谓结构政策要优化，就是说这五年时间我们要完成发展动力的转换。
This means we have to finish the transition of growth engines during the 5 years.
使经济发展转入创新驱动的轨道。
We should make our economy to be innovation oriented.
在具体操作上，就是五项任务，我们叫做去产能、这个去库存、去杠杆、这个降成本。补短板。
There is five tasks focused in building the innovation-oriented economy. They are the cutting of excessive capacity and outdated capacity, destock of the excessive inventory, and financial deleveraging, and also to lower the costs of economy, lower the costs of companies, and also to make up for the weak link of economic development.
去产能、去库存、去杠杆，实际上就是四个字：市场出清。
The cutting of the overcapacity, the destocking of the excessive inventory, and the deleveraging. I think this is to make to cut the over.Capacity of the market and to make the market balanced.
这个降成本、补短板，实际上也是四个字：搞活企业。
The lowering of the costs for the companies, and also to make progress in the weak links of the economic progress. I think this is to give vitality to the economy and companies.
第五句话叫做微观政策要活。
The fifth sentence, I think, is to have an flexible macro policies for the economy.
主要内容就是深化企业改革。
And the main contents is to deepen the reform for the enterprises.
减轻企业负担。
To lower the costs for the enterprises.
第六句话叫做环境政策要紧。
The sixth sentence I want to share with you is to tighten the environment policy.
那意思就是说我们要实行历史上最严厉的环境保护政策。
This means we will implement the most strict policy, environment protection policy.
在气候气变问题，这个治污染防治方面，我们能够比“十二五”做出更大的贡献。
And we want to make better programs compared to the 12th Five-Year Plan in the field of climate change and pollution control.
这个第七句话呢，叫做社会政策要兜底。
The seventh sentence I want to share with you is to have a social security policy to make sure to secure the basic livelihood of the people.
这十三五期间啊，因为我们要进行这个结构改革，企业改革，不可避免的有一部分职工是要下岗的。对于这些职工呢，我们要通过社会保障措施，加以保障。
During the 13th Five-Year Plan, there will be structural reform from the supply side, and there will be reform of the companies. So, there is indefinitely the layoffs. I think we must have the stable social security policies to make the layoffs to have a basic livelihood.
社会保障体系在这个期间呢也要基本成型。
The social security policies should be formulated during this period.
使它成为社会和谐的安全法。
I think this is very essential to the social stable society and the security.
这个第八句话叫做改革政策要实。
And the eighth sentence I want to share with you is we should have practical measures for reform.
我们党的十八届三中全会做出一个全面深化改革的决定。我们现在的改革和三十年前的改革已经不一样了。现在过去呢，我们把好改的都改了，现在改革进入了深水区，我们是在啃硬骨头，难度非常大。
During the third plenary session of the 18th Central Committee of CPC, we have made the decision to deepening our reform and opening up. I think we have entered a new phase of reform because during the past 30 years, we have done what we can do. That were the easier tasks. And now we are facing the serious challenge.
第九句话叫做分配政策要公平。
The ninth sentence I want to share with you too is to make more equality distribution system.
这是我们改革和发展的目的，就是让全体人民共享改革发展的成果。
I think this is the objective of our reform and opening up is to make it possible for the people to share the fruits of our reform and opening up.
也为我们这个社会更加公平正义提供经济基础。
And for the equity and the justice of the society, we should provide a good base for this.
最后一句话叫做就业政策要优先。
The tenth sentence I want to share with you in this aspect is to have a good employment policy.
今年的国民我们年度计划把充分就业作为第一目标。
For this year's plan, to have a good employment situation in China actually is the major objective.
十三五期间我们将要有这个三亿多农民 按照不同方式得到城市化按新型城镇化的安置。
During the 13th, next 5 years, the 13th five-year plan, during this time frame, we will have 300 million rural residents in China to be urbanized.
每年都将有600多万大学生就业。
And every year, we will have 6 million graduates from universities to find job.
所以从今年开始，整个"十三五"期间，就业政策将是我们考虑优先的政策。
So the employment policy will be priority for us in the next 5 years.
我们怎么做？大体上概括起来就是十句话。我们按照这样的措施，这样的这个施工图干下去，五年之后。中国将建成全面小康社会。
So, just now I've shared with you the how we do it. The 10 sentences concluded is the conclusion of how we are going to do it. I think this is an implementation plan of the 13th five-year plan. And after this, we will achieve the building of moderate prosperous society in China.
经过"十三五"的努力。再加上和后边的"十四五"相衔接，大体上到2023年左右，我们人均国内生产总值就将超过12,500到13,000美元。
So after the 13th five-year plan, and also afterwards, we will have the 14th five-year plan.So I think by the year 2023, the per capita GDP in China will surpass $12,500.
国内生产总值将超过100万亿以上。
And the GDP of China will surpass $100 trillion.
这是说的人民币，如果是美元就不得了了。
Oh, this is sorry, this is yuan, RMB, not US dollars.
到那时候，我们将开启我们党提出的第二步战略目标，就叫做到2050年，中华人民共和国建国100周年的时候实现现代化。
At that time, we will have new strategic goals, that is to by the year 2050, we will build a modernized country. That is the centenary goal for China.
这就是我今天讲的内容。我们做了什么？我们要做什么？我们怎么做？实际上，我给大家简略的介绍了中国的发展情况、发展设想和我们十四五年规划的这个制定过程。希望我讲的这些呢，对大家能够有用。
This is what I want to share with you. What we've done, what we are going to do, and how we do it, and just give you some ideas of the development in China and what our planning and also the process of the decision making of the five-year plans. Hope it will give the information you want to know.
感谢大家呢，花了这么长时间听我这么冗长的演讲。使我既受感动又受鼓舞，谢谢。
Thank you for your patience for my long speech. I have been very encouraged by you. Thank you.